Hi everyone, welcome to today's class continuation. So the accounting reliability, okay? So this reliability refers to whether the financial information can be verified and used consistently by investors and creditors with the same result. So basically this reliability refers to the trustworthiness of a financial statement. So because if the decision makers cannot trust what is on the financial statement, the financial reporting as a general is useless. So, because that why the FASB, okay, is concerned with the reliability of a financial statement investment. So, this is this reliability of financial information is enhanced. So, enhanced by the use of the following accounting concepts. Which is verifiability, neutrality, faithful representation, prudence, completeness, single economic entity concept. Okay. So this is main thing. So mainly the concepts and principle based on the same thing. So verifiability, okay. So verifiability means this is information is verifiable when multiple independent measures are used to come up with the same same results. So in other words, the auditors and other third parties can measure and evaluate the company's financial statement accounts and end up with the same result. So if the auditors can't verify financial information, the auditors can't issue an unqualified opinion. Okay, the next one is under verifiability. Okay, under verifiability, the next one is a meaning. So meaning we have finished. After that, faithful representation. So the faithful representation means it is the information presented in financial statements should faithfully represent the transaction and events that occurred during the period. So this representation requires the transaction event should be accounted for a manner that represent their true economic substance. So rather than the mere legal form. So this concept is known as substance over form. So this over form requires if substance's transaction differ from its legal form. It is a such transactions should be accounted for in accordance with its substance and economic reality. Okay. Next one is neutrality. Neutrality means the information contained in a financial statement must be free from bias. Okay. It should reflect the balanced view of affairs of the company without attempting to present them in a favored light. So because the information may be deliberately biased. Okay. So which should not be fraudulent manner. For their favor, they do not do that. Okay, so to reduce the tax, they will reduce the accounting profits. If the company is going in a loss, but for the investors, they need to go show the real. They should not need to show the real fact to the shareholders. Means they will not. Show the loss value. Okay, so by this it has a type. The first one is deliberate bias. Deliberate means it occurs when circumstances conditions cause management to intentionally mistake. So it's voluntary they did the mistakes with the known mistakes. Okay, so systematic bias means it is a type of system bias. So it is a computer overcome over the overtime. So it is according to the systems have developed in an inherent tendency. It may be some OS issues. It may be some software development programs issues like that. Okay. And the next one is prudence. So prudence means it is a cautiousness. Okay, caution with a judgment. Okay, they are waiting with a caution. So mainly known as the wise, which means a caution. Okay. So the ability to govern and discipline oneself to use the reason. what is a it is a good judgment. Prudence means it is a good judgment. So based on this, what it means it is a preparation of financial statement require the use of professional judgment in the adoption of accountancy policy and estimates. So this requires that accountants should exercise a degree of caution in the adoption of policies. So this rationale behind the prudence is that company should not recognize an asset at a value that is higher than the amount which is expected to recover from its sale or use. So this is conversely, liabilities of an entity should not be presented below the amount that is likely to be paid in its respect in the futures. Okay. So next one is, there is an inherent risk that assets and incomes of an entity are more likely to be overstated than understated by the management, whereas liabilities and expenses are more likely to understand. So the risk arises from the fact that companies often benefit from a better reported profitability and lower gearing in the form of a cheaper source of a finance. This is a risk that leverage offered in a choice of accounting policies. So this estimates may result in a bias in the preparation of financial statements. The next one is completeness. Completeness means it is a reliability of information contained in the financial statement is achieved only if the complete financial information is provided relevant to the business and financial decisions needs of the users. So therefore, information must be complete in all material respects. Okay, based on this, the incomplete information reduces not only the relevance of the financial statements, it also decreases the reliability, since the users will be basing their decision on information which only presents the partial value of the affairs of the entity. And the next one is single economic entity concept. So which is mean by consolidation accounting. So consolidation accounting is a group of companies where they prepare the basis single economic entity concept. Okay, so by this definition is, it is suggests that just the company associated with each other through the virtue of common control operates as a single economic unit, and therefore the consolidated financial statements of a group of companies should reflect the essence of such arrangement. Okay, the explanation is, if the consolidated financial statement of a group of companies must be prepared as if the entire group of constitute in a single entry in order to avoid misrepresentation of the scale of group activities. So it is therefore necessary to eliminate the effects of the intercompany transaction and balances during the consolidation of group accounts, such as the following. The first one is, intercompany sales and purchase, and intercompany payables and receivables, intercompany payments such as a dividend, royalties, head office charges. Okay, you can go through the examples. If you have any doubts in these sums, you can ask me. I'll explain it later. Then language of a business. So business language. So what the business language means, there are three main languages: accounting, finance, economics. So while there are many other disciplines in a business, such as a marketing, human resource operation, but it is a core principle terminology behind accounting, finance, economics. So that derives decisions according to the business. So what is mainly known as it is a core business decision making unit. So this is decision making under the uncertainty. The languages of accounting and finance, forward looking information, and economics, external forces. Okay, so by this, the first one is accounting. So accounting is a main thing. It is a importance to start a solid understanding of the accounting system. So how it works and how the financial statement all put together, they need to check it out with that accounting. So within a business, the accounting language is a critical to understand, yet far too few people properly understand it, because the companies produce three main financial statements, which are balance sheet, income statement, and cash flow statement. So within the each financial statement, there is a long list of terms that are very important to understand are the language. Okay, so the language of a business is in accounting, so mainly can easily be covered with our free courses, means accounting fundamentals, reading financial statements. So thus, financial businesses need a way to keep track of their overall financial positions, which includes tracking revenues, expenses, capital, and other items. So the rules based on the system of accounting allows companies to track these items and communicate the results to a wide range of interested parties. Okay, The next one is a finance. Once you have a solid understanding of the accounting language, it is equally important to understand the language of a finance, because accounting is the backward looking. So while finance is the forward looking, therefore it's critical to understand making process at companies. So the accounting numbers that have been prepared by the accountants need to be analyzed and interpreted to create a forward looking projections about what might happen in the future. Okay, so this rules based on a system of accounting is a great ensuring accurate, consistent and reliable information, but it doesn't necessarily indicate where value is being created or destroyed. The language of a finance is assessing value, looking into the future, rates of return and allocating capital. The third language of a business is economics. So it is a third distinct language because it looks externally outside the organization at a loss. So which behavior in the markets, governments and individuals. So it's a one thing to making a financial forecast using financial methods, but it's another entirely to make sure that the forecast is supported by the sound understanding of supply and demand, the consumer preferences, price sensitivity. So these language of economics is a critical at a business. Do not exist vacuum. There are subject to external forces, and knowing how those forces work in absolutely critical. So in the realm economics, the managers are speaking about supply and demand. This is the main thing in economics and consumer preferences. Then in different curves, it's based on upwards or downwards. Okay, then substitutes, price elasticity. So there are of course many more economic principles to understand, but these are some of the key components to understand the business. So an example of the different business languages. So which imagine a company faced with the decisions of should we produce a new product or not, like that. Okay, for they have given examples for three languages. Okay, for accounting, based on the historical accounting information, it would be possible to make it. Okay, the past financial statement or accounting reports could tell you the average cost of productions, which includes labor, rent, overhead. So by this, they need a fully baked number of because the accountants always allocate a cost overhead across the divisions. And finance, using the some financial statement, it would be looking forward, the forward looking lens. So this analyze would look at the true cost and cash flow requires. Third one, economics. It is a properly price the new product and a forecast demand for it. So solid understanding in the supply and demand as well as the other substitute goods and price. So this economic lens may say here is a reasonable range of prices to charge, okay, and here is the reasonable estimate the value that can be sold at that price. The next one is combining all three business languages. So which means at this post, a manager can take accountant's view of smooth and cost. Okay, so the finance view of cash flow and the economics view of price and volume to make an informed decision. So as mentioned above, the business is the decision making under uncertainty. So even with a complete understanding of three languages of business, it may be hard to make a right decision. And the next one, execution of other languages. So you may be asking, are not marketing, operations, human resources, technology and other areas of a business important language as we will. Okay, yes, the difference that though it, this is that they are all part of execution that rather than the core decision making process. For this, having a good idea for marketing campaign should be drive to decision making, produce a new product. Instead of a marketing should play a critical role and the executing plan once the decision has been made based on the accounting sound and finance and economic principles. Okay, the next one is financial terms. What are the financial terms they have having? Okay, the first one is accounts receivable. So which means money owed to you by clients and other payers for a services you have performed. So accounts receivable is a current asset that can be found in a balance sheet. Assets, it is a total resources, monetary and individual or a business. They include such cash, stocks, bonds, real estate, equity, money you are owned, okay, and property. So this assets can be found on your balance sheet, asset side. And for balance sheet, it is known as a financial condition statement, which has assets and liabilities, so which represent the practice of overall financial position as at a given point of time. Then current asset means which we can transfer into your cash and current liabilities which we have to pay within a 1 year. Okay, that's in the depreciation amount of expenses during the specific time of period. The assets value to the they will lose their value, so that is a depreciation. Equity means the amount of the practice total assets you actually own. Okay, so not financed with the debt. So depending the legal model, the ownership of your practice equity may concerns. I'm telling one by one. Okay, and for expenses means the cost associated with the providing services running your practice over the period of a time. And fixed assets means long term assets which is not expected to turn into cash sold assumed during the coming years. Next, income statement, mainly known as it is a profit and loss statement. This statement is the earning, so that shows your revenue, expenses, profit in a specific period of time. And long term, okay, I left the one thing. Okay, long term liabilities, so it is owned for a debts that will not become a due for at least 1 year. Okay, this is long term liabilities, can be found in your balance sheet. Then marketable securities means stocks, in other investments that have even demanded converted into cash which can sold quickly. And net account receivable means the total accounts receivable minus an estimate for uncollectibles which is not collectible. Okay, so next one, net income. It is a difference between a total revenue and total expenses. And non-operating revenue, so which is it is generated by the things that are not directly related to the service you offer. So this non-operating revenue include things such as interest income, gains, losses and other non-operating transactions. Then operating revenue, so which means it is generated from day-to-day operations of your properties, so this can be found on your income statement. Next one, profit is this is also known as a net income or earnings, the amount of money your practices make the paying operating expenses, taxes, other current expenses. This profit can be found in your income statement or a profit and loss account. Okay, and next one is a revenue. So revenue, money collected from that you have expected to collect from providing services. So this revenue can be found in income statement. Next one is a total assets, which can sum of the practice current asset and fixed asset, total asset. Okay, total liabilities, current and long term liabilities equal to total liabilities. And total revenue is equal to non-operating revenue, operating and non-operating revenue, total revenues. So the next one is uncollectibles. So based on this, the account can be cannot be collected because the client or a payer is not able or willing to pay. So the financial calculations such as a days cash on hand, consider using estimate uncollectible payers based on the historical data about the average percent of receivable you are typically unable to collect. So these are the financial terms mainly which we gonna see. So just go through that, just see what is what. Okay, what is accounts receivable means what, like that, don't expand more. So based on this, next we have business and financial terms. Okay, business and financial terminology, so which has a 60, I think so. One sec. So 60, okay. So we'll see one by one. If you don't know anything, you can ask me. The same thing, the terms. It will come one by one. I am all set, it said. Accrual, bias, accruals, assets. Okay. So based on this, what I'm going to, accounts payable, you already know. Okay. Which we have to pay is account payable, which we have to receive is account receivable. Accrual basis means it is a recording income when it is actually earned our expenses. So when it's actually earned our expenses is equal to accrual basis. Okay, this accrual may be in a expenses or income. Okay, then accrual same thing, it is referring the expenses. Accrual basis means it is a earned. Accruals means it is a expenses. So wages, payrolls, tax, common examples. Okay. Okay, this is the assets you know, balance sheet know. Bookkeeping means entering day-to-day transactions, which is under bookkeeping journals. Okay. The next one is capital, no. Working capital, no. Assets mainly known as what is working capital? it is mainly known as working capital is fixed capital, working capital, another business finance. So which consists of working capital. Okay, this is the cash on hand or instruments that can be converted into cash quickly. Cash flow projections means it will depend on educated cash flow projections. So which will plan ahead upcoming expenditure and working capital, you need to depend on previous cash flow patterns. So these patterns will give you a look at the how when you receive and spend your cash. Depreciation we know, fixed asset no, gross profit, what is gross profit, sales cost, expenses. Okay, so this that's a one sec. So mainly how we calculate the gross profit: raw materials, manufacturing expenses, labors minus selling, labor cost, marketing, transportation of goods. Okay, like that we sold the gross profit, sales minus cost of expenses, so which are under this. Okay, the next one is income statement. So income statement mainly known as lenders, investors, profit and loss account statement. So intangible assets which we cannot see directly, it is a non-physical: goodwill, intellectual property, patents. And liability, the business finance, it is an obligation to repay or settle the debt. Okay, so liquidity means which we can convert into cash, a full market value. Profit and loss statement we know, it is a income statement, same thing. Okay, statement of a cash flow we know, statement of shareholders equity we know. And annual percentage rate means it represent yearly real cost of a loan including all interest and fees. So this total amount of interest to be paid on the basis of original amount loaned. So appraisal means for the some professional opinion, they will give some appraisal like increasing in a salary, or they will provide a cab, they will provide a vehicle to follow, like that it is appraisal. So which it is in the business, how they will provide, need one or more three types of appraisal: real estate, equipment and business value. And balloon loan means it is a loan that is structured to sell the small business owners to make a regular repayments. So which is predetermined schedule, one much larger payments or a balloon payment. So these can be attractive new business because the payments are smaller at the outset when the business is more likely to be facing strict financial constraints. The next one is bankrupt. It is a reduction or repayment of a debts. It's called a bankrupt. And bootstrapping means using own money to finance, to start up or a growth of a business. So think of it's being own investors. Once the business is up running successfully, a finance terms or a definition will all refers to the one who invested. Okay, you can reinvest the amount which you have earned. So business credit report. So which means it is a personal credit report. Lenders look at the determine risk factors, making personal loans, business, and generate the credit reports. Credit score means which is calculated based on the information found in the business credit report. Same thing. So collateral. Collateral means it is a pledge as a security, the instrument called a collateral. The any asset that you pledge as a security is called a collateral. The next one is credit limit. So some credit limit they will have. Usually it comes with a credit limit. It means a business line. Okay, so maximum amount that you can use at any given time, it is said that you reach your credit limit, max out your credit when you borrow up or exceed the number. So this misaligned of a credit can be especially useful if your business is seasonal or if the income extremely unpredictable. The next one is debt consolidation. So consolidations of several loans and various payments, you might want to consider business debt consolidation. So it is the process that let you combine multiple loans into a single loan. So the advantages of possibly reducing the interest rates on the borrowed funds as well as lowering the total amount you repay each month. So businesses use the tool to help to remove the cash flows. The next one, debt service coverage ratio. So which means the business finance term or a definition. So it is the ratio cash your business has available for paying services it debts. So this debt payments include making a principal interest payments on a loan you are requesting. And the debt financing means can include a borrowing from a bank's business credit cards, lines, credit, personal loans, merchant cash advances. Then equity financing. So it is act of using investors' funds, which is the exchange of a piece or a share of a business, is another way to raise capital. FICO score. FICO means fair as a corporations. Okay. So hence it is the name of FICO. FICO. Fair Isaac Corporations. So it is a credit score used by the potential lenders for evaluating the wisdom of entering contract with you or your business. Okay. Then financial statements, we all know that shareholders' equity and fixed interest rate. We all know that floating interest rate. Floating means it will be changed. Okay. Increase or decrease. Then guarantor means one you need to start a business, mean lenders might to have a give a guarantor. So one who sign for you to make your business go well and pay, have to payment mean, if you cannot pay the amount, if you cannot pay the obligations which you have signed, the guarantor have to pay the repayment the obligations. Then interest rate, one for the loan they are making the interest rate. And the next one is invoice factoring or financing. So if your business has a significant amount of open invoice, it should be outstanding, you may contact a factoring company and have them purchase invoice discount. Lien. So then next one is a definition is a creditorial legal claim to the collateral pledged on a security loan. Okay. So line of credit means once you have made an unsecured amount of the funds available, so it is a draw when capital is needed. It is a line of credit. It is a short-term funding option. Okay. Loan to value means LTV. This is the ratio of fair market value asset of compared to the loan that will fund it. And long-term debt, so which means it is any loan products with a total repayment schedule, which is longer one more year, they considered long-term. Then micro loan means the loan make through non-profit community based on the organization, and they are more the amount under the $50,000. And personal guarantee means same as a guarantor. So you are seeking a financial as a very new business, you have high value asset means the collateral, you may be asked for a lender to sign the statement. So personal guarantee. The principal means, so loan instrument made of three parts. So principal, interest, fees. So once you have get the amount, the principal amount means the first amount which you got from a loan. And revolving line of credit means the financial term, it is defined on funding options similar to the standard of line credit. And secured loan, so which means many lenders will require some form of security when loaning money. So when this happens, this business finance term definition is secured loans. And the next one is term loan. So it is debt financing tools used to raise the needs and funds for your small businesses. And secured means not backed by collateral or called unsecured. So these type of loans represent the higher risk for the lenders. Then articles of incorporation. So this means it is a legal documentation of a business creditor, including name, type of a business. So this type of business structure in incorporation, this paperwork is one of the first tasks you will complete when you officially start your business. And the next one is business articles of incorporation. I already said, so business plan, tool for demonstrating how you want to establish a small business to large. Okay, then employer identification number, EIN. So once the Internal Revenue Service, they will give the EIN number. When you start a small business, you have to assign and mail to the business address. Franchise agreement means for a small business entrepreneurs entering the franchise agreement with, it is a branch, okay, so a branch to the various places. So the agreement made between you and your larger company gives you the right to operate as a satellite of a larger company in a certain territory. And the next one is net worth. So this finance terms and definition is an expression of your business total value. So as determined by your total current asset less total liabilities currently owned by the business. So retained earnings, it's a term of represent any profits earned that are retained in a business. Tax lien means if your business fails to pay the tax owned by or a designing government entity, namely, you may find your assets seized by the claim of a tax lien. So the government cannot only seize your asset for liquidation to resolve that tax debt. So, but they can also change your penalties on the amount you owe. Then timeliness of accounting information. Okay. So mainly based on this, we have seen all things. So barriers which we didn't follow. So the first one is depreciation, and depreciation expense adjusted will affect the profits. So it is necessary to consider the age of the function. So that may be decided asset management. Then next one is LIFO FIFO. LIFO inventory adjustment supplies should be converted into a FIFO. Okay, a backup means backup is the company ability to pay and cover expenses by removing the load. And financial adjustment reformulation of the sum of the changes after a few calculation and the points of the TSB. Okay, some difficulties in and weakness in the information financial analysis means information access information, thousands of companies from around the world has been widely available in recent years. So these sources of information in a countless numbers up through World's Wide Web. The companies in the world today have website and annual report are available for a free charge from various other sources. The second one is timeliness of information. So which is the financial reports, annual reports to the regulators vary in each country, barriers of language and terminology, and foreign currency issues and differences in the type of format of financial statements. So these are the thing, the difficulties, weakness in international financial analysis. By this class is over. We'll meet you all in the next class. Take care all.